Please help me welcome to the stage, International Ensemble BRAVO!
What we're going to do is get one suggestion from you. That suggestion is going to inspire James to play something. What he plays will then inspire us for our set. So to get James inspired, can I get a favorite lyric from a song?
Hello.
Just a little trash. We could try something.
come now, Sally. You know this is a fool's errand.
No. I'm joining the war effort.
The war is a million miles away at this point.
I've got legs.
And I want you to keep them. Sally, you know you're my best girl. Can't have you going off to that savage land of bullets, blood, and gold.
Ooh, sounds so sexy, though.
I agree, war is very sexy and glorious. However, I can't let you go. My heart would simply burst if yours were to be shot out of your body by a mortar shell.
Can't let me go, Sam?
Of course not.
Who said I need your permission? I'm a grown woman, aren't I?
Not reason enough to stay, it'd simply break me in two. I'd rather go off and just murder all those poor, poor aliens that invaded a while back.
It's just that I want to see something new.
And kill it.
You do know me, Finn. I'm sorry.
Fine, go. But know that if you leave, I'm not gonna be here when you come back. I'll just sell the house and go somewhere.
Sam, the aliens have taken over everywhere else.
Then I guess I'll find my way into one of their goo pods or whatever. The choice is yours, Sam. You said it yourself, you're a bright young independent woman.
Yes. I didn't say bright, but I am.
Will you?
gotta get a bigger house.
I agree.
Look how big that rat was. His house is minuscule.
I feel as though we've gotten smaller as well. I seem to remember a time in which we were much larger than that rat.
I used to be 5'7".
I used to be 5'6".
Oh, hello, rat. How's it going?
I feel like it's getting smarter.
Very sweet. Were there any like weird bottles on our counter that said drink me? I don't know how this happened. This chair's just three matchsticks and the match head for the seat.
God, what's going on?
David.
Martha? Sorry, I forgot your name for a moment.
I just feel like everything's changed. You know.
Is that so bad?
Ever since we started drinking kombucha. No one really knows what it is.
No, nobody.
You ask someone who's drinking, they're like, I don't know, fermented mushroom tea?
Looks like somebody hocked a loogie in a bottle of iced tea.
And I feel like the day in which we started getting smaller coincides almost directly.
The day we started drinking kombucha. Granted, I will say that my digestion has improved significantly. You remember how I used to be.
I do.
Just a mess.
It was.
It was gross.
But we got smaller and so did our poops.
I tell you. Hell, that rat's doing it every once in me now.
It is.
Man,
is this worth it? Do we want to be tiny forever and regular? Is it worth it? Is this place too great to beg? What means more? Does it mean to be large? What means more? Fate's never in charge. We made a choice. Us down to the size of nuts, and I don't know if this was really worth it.
Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome to the stage the rest of the International Ensemble Bravo!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are International Ensemble Bravo Team James. Yeah. And to inspire us, all we need from you to inspire James is someone share with us your happy place.
Here.
Here.
Thank you.
it went off.
Yeah?
Like football.
Did you make him proud? Was he ashamed of the fact that his son was an athlete? You're more of the book guy.
I read a lot. Keep books outside.
I know.
That's my library.
Yeah?
Got another one inside.
I notice a lot of things. I have a broad scope.
You seem pretty smart, Brian.
Smart, observant. You know, the human mind only uses about 18% of what's actually up there. I like to think that I just use 19%.
Wow. I never met anyone else who's interested in books. Around here, people love football, Sunday this and Monday that.
Yeah. It's just you and your wife really like books around here.
Yeah.
Your beautiful blonde-haired wife who left the house around 6:30 this morning.
That was oddly specific. Yeah, we like to read together and go to book clubs and, you know, we have double-decker memberships at the library.
Yeah. So does Todd from her office.
What?
Todd Cahill from your wife's office? He also has a double-decker book membership.
They share a cubicle at work. I've gone to their office function.
Sometimes they reach for the same pen. Their hands graze one another. And they look up. And they laugh nervously. One or both of them thinks it might mean more. Welcome to Charleston.
Wow. This is you're telling me my wife is being literally unfaithful.
Well, I wouldn't go so far as to say that she's being unfaithful. Why, if that was unfaithful, everybody in this town would be unfaithful.
Okay. Good. Oh, okay. I was worried there for a second that you were intimating that. So there was a problem between my wife and me.
Nah, it's never gone past the occasional hands brushing up against each other. But then again, your wife has only been on the job 12 days.
Okay, you're starting to freak me out a little
bit. Don't be. Told you, it's just that I use 1% more of my mind, I think, than anybody else. It's not like I have a superpower or anything. It's not like I'm stronger than anybody else in this town. It's not like I can read minds. It's not like my skin can just sense things when I touch things. Everything that's ever been there in an area before. I'm not a superhuman person.
No, I never said that.
Just a regular kid in
That's pretty heavy stuff, man. You want some Cheetos? I'm done. I had like a bunch of Cheetos, and then I had like the last Cheeto. You know, like the last one I was gonna have. Because it was like, oh, that's enough Cheetos. Sometimes junk food makes me feel better, though, you know? I'm sorry your parents are getting divorced. You can stay the night if you want.
Thanks.
You still seem sad.
You know, it's just, I feel like even though I'm old,
right,
like older,
right,
I feel like I never really got to see my parents be together. So the fact that they're divorcing is confusing because it, none of it makes sense, you know? Like together they didn't make sense, and divorcing it doesn't make sense. Only thing that makes sense are these Cheetos.
That's what I'm saying.
My mom wants my dad to move out by the end of the month.
I'm sorry I'm laughing. It's just, where's he gonna go? Hey, dad can sit here if he wants.
Really?
Yeah. I got a big room.
Would your parents be okay with that?
I'll ask my dad. He'll say ask my mom. I won't ask my mom, and then I'll tell my dad my mom said it was okay.
You're the best friend, Stacy. You took me in, you gave me Cheetos.
That's what I do.
And now you're giving my dad a place to live?
Yeah.
Oh, who could say? It looks like Don't mind that one. You could choose a different one, or there's her jewelry you could pick from.
Sure. Why does Grandma want me to have this painting?
Well, Loretta, that is for her to know and for you to find out.
Do you think it's because I'm the most sexually reserved of all the grandchildren?
Now, as your great aunt, I don't want to say for sure, but yes.
You know, I'm a grown-ass woman. I'm 88 years old. And if I could give you one piece of advice, it's loosen up a bit. I lose.
Yes, very loose.
Dancing. Look at this line. What does it remind you of?
Grandmother.
Is it an ocean or is it a sea? Look at this circle. What does it remind you of?
Grandma.
Is it the moon?
Your arms are making wiggly.